I'm back again. Sorry I've been away for a while, I've been wrestling with a walrus. So, hello. This is another vlog in my quest to become an online celebrity revered by millions and actually known by none. Oh, in case you're wondering, the scarf and hat, but because there's a good 9 inches of snow outside. Snow day! So this vlog is about television. I don't know exactly what the main focus will be, but I'm sure I'll have thought of one by the end of the vlog. So I've just been watching the television. I just saw an advert for a new show. Something about Vampire Diaries. It's basically a teen vampire show. My God, another one. Seriously, this craze about vampires is spreading faster than Lindsay Lohan's legs at a televised lesbian convention. Booyah. Anyway, that is not the focus of this. A point I do want to make is a point about reality television. Celebrity Big Brother has started again. Reality television is the lowest form of all television, but it gets the highest amount of views. Anyone who respects television shows at all should hate them. There's no script, no actors, little production cost, but yet the show makes so much money. I mean, Big Brother is literally Satan's kind of television. A bunch of uninteresting, dim-witted, stereotypical, undeserving, cringeworthy, breast-showing, argumentative load of twats. Competing for money by just being in a house. Ooh, people watch this because it's like real life. No, it is not. Sure, some things that go on may be funny or interesting to watch because they portray some form of similarity to real life. But try paying that much attention to real life, and you will see that life is far more interesting than what goes on in that house. Jeez. Excuse me, I need to go cool down. When I return, I will be talking about the musical reality TV shows, like The X Factor. Okay, The X Factor. Where do I begin? In fact, I don't think there is a point where you can begin. I absolutely 100% really detest that show. What the hell was that? Anyway, I despise the show. People who can sing go on there, and then the people who cannot sing go on there. And I mean, really cannot sing. I am not a brilliant singer, but I mean, to go on television when you have a voice like that. Yes, I know the majority of the time they were doing it to get on the TV or just for a bet or a laugh or something. But sometimes there are genuinely people that go in there thinking they can sing. And that is when it scares me. These people really believe they can sing. I mean, okay, self-delusion isn't that bad. I mean, I am an actor, so I have to believe I can act.
You wanna play? You wanna play? Well, let's play a game called Time for You to Die.
Like I was saying, self-delusion isn't that bad. But it's the way the show exploits it. They edit the show to make them seem like complete berks, and then they give them more screen time than the ones who can sing. It's like they're rewarding them for not being able to sing, but in the most patronising way ever. And that is the thing that really winds me up. And through it all, she offers me protection, a lot of love and affection, whether I'm right or wrong. Weird. Anyway, now onto the thing that really annoys me. I sit there and I watch them. I watch them all. Not because I like them, but because everybody talks about them, and I don't want to miss out on a common conversation topic. That is extremely shallow, I know. But that is why I hate them. They have a grip over me, similar to the grip Hagrid has over Joe Pasquale's balls. The only reason I know who Joe Pasquale is because he was on that damn I'm a Celebrity television. See, that is the grip it has on me. It drives me insane. It does just... I best go answer that, hang on.
Hello?
Ah, hello there. I finally have the screen all to myself. Soon, this won't be Jack's vlog. It will be mine. Don't tell him, but I've put an audition form for him into the next X Factor. Me and him, we're gonna duet. It's gonna be some good shit. That's right. I swore on camera. I'm a badass puppet. My shirt says, "Hockey is my life." That's how badass I am. The name is Mozzarella. Yes, it is a girl's name, but I am an hermaphrodite, so it's fine. Anyway, best disappear quickly.
Sorry about that. Someone phoned me up and asked me how big my tits were. I then had to go measure my bra size before I could tell him. Turns out, they're a small, with a cup-sized B. He hung up, without saying goodbye. Where are manners these days? Oh, I don't know, what are they like? On a final note, I'd like to take this opportunity to advertise a friend of mine on YouTube. No, not in that way, he's not like a prostitute or anything. His name's audioslavekid, you should check him out. He does a mixture of things, he does music remixes, he does vlogs. Mine are better, of course, but he still does them. And actually, he shouted me out, so I thought, hey, I'll shout him back out. Shout him back out? No, it doesn't really work. But check his site out, I'll put it in the link or something. On a final note, I would just like to say that there was no point at all to this vlog, except for me expressing my hatred for reality television. They are pathetic, but interesting. Kinda like midget wrestlers. Goodbye. That'll do. So, you ready to practice?
You bet.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, go.
I can be your hero, baby. I can kiss away the pain. I will stand by you forever. You can take my breath away.
If I touched your lips, would you laugh? Oh, please tell me this. Now would you die?
They are pathetic, but interesting. Kind of like when you go to do a crap in the toilet, but you don't actually do one, and then you feel kind of embarrassed because you've been to the toilet for nothing. They are pathetic, but interesting. Kind of like watching the disabled Olympics.
I'm so sorry.